Hello everyone. Welcome to X Markets, the fastest and most accurate information channel about Xness. Continuing the video series guiding the use of the MetaTrader 5 platform on Xness, in this video, I will guide you on how to log in your account to the trading platform and introduce you to the toolbars of this platform, helping you access and use the MT5 trading platform in the best way. This is the Xness Market Channel, where we provide the most useful information about trading activities on the Xness platform. We are a leading development partner of Xness. If you're new to Xness Market, make sure to hit the subscribe button to stay updated with our latest videos. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below, and our team will get back to you as soon as possible. You'll find the registration guide and the latest Xness updates in the video description and pinned comment. Besides this channel, you can also visit our Xness Market website to explore more about Xness. This is the interface of the MetaTrader 5 Xness platform. And on this trading platform, I have already logged in an account. In the bottom part, you can see the capital in the account. And when you log into the trading platform like this, you will see that the product information tables flash, showing the price increase and decrease of the product. To log an account into the trading platform, we need to have the account information. For example, here, when I go into my personal area, I have retrieved the information of a demo account on the MetaTrader 5 platform like this. You need to note that we must retrieve the correct account on the MetaTrader 5 platform to be able to log in. If we mistakenly retrieve a MetaTrader 4 account, we will not be able to log in. To log in, we need three pieces of information. First, the account ID. Second, the account server or account host. And third, the account password. The trading account password is what we set when we created the account. And that password is not saved in the account information table like this. To display the account information table, you can perform a very quick operation. Find the three-dot icon corresponding to the account you want to retrieve information from. Click on it, then find the account information. And the account information table will appear like this. Next, we will proceed to log the account into the trading platform. We will find the Navigator toolbar. To display this Navigator toolbar, you go to the View section and select Navigator. Or you can also press Ctrl plus N and the Navigator toolbar will appear. In this section, right-click on the Account section and select Login to Trade Account. Then, you will copy the information of this account. For example, here, I will copy the account ID. I click this button. Next, I will paste the account ID into the Login section. Then I will enter the account password. On the right side, we still check save password. If we leave it like this, when we switch back and forth between trading accounts that we have previously logged in, we will be able to switch very easily because it has already saved the information for us. When we switch back and forth like that, we just need to double click on the account we want to log in. Then click OK, and we have logged in. No need to re-enter information. Continuing the login process for this account, we will enter the server information for the account. Here, you can see that for this account, its server is Xness MT5 Trial 8. So I will copy this information. Then I will go to the server section here. I will paste the account's server into this server section. You can also click the arrow and select the server of the account you want to log in. After entering the three information fields above, we click OK. When you click OK, we will be logged into the account like this. At that time, there will be a notification email. And if you check the toolbox section below, and go to the trade tab, you will see that the capital in the account is already displayed here. The account information will appear in the Navigator section. And with the account successfully logged into the trading platform, we can now proceed to trade and earn money in the Forex field. However, before proceeding to trade, we will learn more about this trading platform as well as its settings. I will maximize the chart section to be able to see the product chart more clearly. I will minimize these information sections. Moving on to the next section, I will introduce you to the toolbars of this trading platform. We will focus on the first three toolbars, the line study bar. The second is the time frame bar. And the third is the standard bar. So, with MetaTrader 5, we will need to use these three toolbars. These three toolbars contain many different functional tabs. Introducing the timeframe bar first. This time frame bar will provide us with different time frames. For example, here I select the H1 time frame. So when I set the H1 time frame, each candle here will be formed after 1 hour. If I select the H4 time frame, each candle here will be formed after 4 hours. D1 is a daily candle. W1 is a weekly candle. MN is a monthly candle. And the subsequent time frames from M30 downwards will correspond to the number of minutes it takes for that candle to form. For the MetaTrader 5 platform, it provides us with many different time frames. You can find more time frames by right-clicking on the bottom part of this time frame bar and selecting Customize. You can see that in the left column, there are many other time frames. And when you move those time frames from the left column to the right column, you will be able to display more time frames in this time frame bar. Any time frame you don't want to use, you can move it from the right column to the left column by selecting the corresponding time frame and then selecting Remove. After setting up, click Close. The second toolbar we need to pay attention to is the standard bar. This standard bar has many functional tabs within it. Here, you should pay attention to some main functional tabs. The first functional tab you need to pay attention to is the New Order tab, which has a plus sign icon. When you click on it, you can execute trading orders. The second tab is the Algo Trading tab. When you click on this tab, you can activate trading robots. However, if you have already dragged the robots onto the screen and set them up, but you haven't clicked this button and it still shows a red square like this, the robot is not yet active. In this part, we can set the display for the screen. Whether you display it as Japanese candlesticks, bar charts, or line charts, typically, here we just keep it as Japanese candlesticks. And these two tabs help us zoom in and out of the screen, making it easier for us to observe the chart. This tab helps us manage the display of product windows like this. You can see here I have 4 product charts open. And if I click this button, those 4 product charts will appear in 4 corners like this, allowing me to observe different charts simultaneously. If I want to maximize a chart, I will click on one of the charts. I click here. Next is the scroll tab. This scroll tab is for scrolling the screen. When you enable this tab, during the process of viewing the product chart, when you drag the chart back to view historical data, it will always automatically scroll the chart back to the left so that you can observe the current price action of the candles like this. So, if I turn this off, I can freely scroll back to the past. And if I'm in the past like this and I want to see the current candles, I will click this button again, the scroll button, and it will scroll the chart back so I can see the current candles. And currently, you see that the chart is quite close to the right side of the screen, which makes it difficult for me to observe the current price action. To push the chart to the left, creating some space from the right side so I can observe the current price chart more easily, I will click the button next to it, the chart shift button. So, when I click the chart shift button, it has pushed the chart to the left, and it will help me observe this cluster of candles more easily. I can adjust the distance of this cluster of candles from the right side by clicking and holding here, then dragging to the desired position. If you want to take a screenshot, you can click this button. It can save the screen as an image and has many different options. But this is rarely used. Some other functional tabs on this side are very rarely used. So if you have time, you can explore them further. Here, I will not introduce this part. On this standard bar, there are some other frequently used toolbars that are not displayed by default. You need to add them. Right-click on this toolbar. Select Customize. Select Navigator. Then click Insert to move it over. Next is the Template section. Click on it and insert it over. These are very frequently used functional tabs. Also, the Market Watch too. You also insert it over. After inserting the necessary functional tabs, I click Close. I will move this up to make it easier to see. These are some of the functional tabs I just added. You can see that with this Navigator tab, I can easily hide or show the section for managing my account. So, I click here, and it will close the Navigator section. I click again, and it will open the Navigator section. The Market Watch section helps us manage the list of products we are monitoring. So, I click here, and it will close. I click again, and it will open. Next is the Templates tab. This Templates tab helps us manage the screen display more easily. And when using it, we can also manage the screen display in a very organized way. So, These are the things to note on the standard bar. The third toolbar we need to pay attention to is the line study bar. This line study bar will provide us with tools to help determine market trends. In addition to the indicators we can install, also include the tools in this line study bar. For example, here you can draw trend lines. You can draw them to know what the resistance levels are. You can draw vertical lines to compare the current price action and evaluate the current price action with the indicators that we additionally install. In this case, I have not installed any indicators here. You can also see the time when this candle appeared. You can also draw trend lines. Or you can draw Fibonacci retracements. You can write on the screen or you can insert special characters. Markers. You can mark price positions. Or you can mark buy positions, sell positions, or arrows, etc. So, with these three toolbars, we can perform all the most necessary functions in our trading process. To use the software, there are also skills in setting up the screen display, as well as executing trading orders, managing trading orders, and how to use indicators and trading robots. I will continue to introduce these parts to you in the upcoming video sections. I will conclude this video here. Thank you for watching the video. Don't forget to give the video a like and click the subscribe button and the bell icon next to it to receive the latest videos when the channel releases them.